नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वील बी डीलिंग अबाउट रिलेशनशिप ऑफ क्लीवेज एंड सिस्टोसिटी टू द मेजर स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, द सिस्टोसिटी एंड दिस क्लीवेज, दीज आर द प्लेन्स ऑफ वीकनेसेस फाउंड इन द रॉक्स. ओके, इन मैनी लोकेलिटीज दिस क्लीवेज बियर्स अ कंसिस्टेंट रिलेशनशिप टू द मेजर स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, एंड दिस सिस्टमेटिक पैटर्न शोन बाई फोल्ड्स एंड क्लीवेज, it is a very important, highly important to solve the complicated field problems. Like in field, we may not encounter the whole fold in a continuous form. Sometimes we encounter just a limb of the fold. Okay, then in order to identify the closures of the fold, where it is whether the closure is on the left or right, or whether it is in any other directions, this relationship between cleavage and folds, these are the tools in the field to determine the closures of the folds. Or okay, now static cleavage is a diagonal to the bedding, means they are at acute angle to the bedding and is more or less parallel to the axial planes of the fold. Okay, in some cases they are confined to incompetent bands, in some cases they are there are regional cleavages as well, which cover throughout the thickness of the argillaceous strata. Similarly, a cleavage that is parallel to the axial plane of fold is of great use in solving structure problems. Its utility is a function of geometrical relationship. Okay, see, as I have told you earlier, that the cleavages which are parallel to the axial planes of the folds, they are immensely useful to determine the structural patterns of rocks, and immensely useful in the field geology. Okay, see here, if the cleavage is vertical, then the axial planes of the fold are vertical and all the beds are right side up, means the strata will be as it is found in the nature. Like these, the lower beds will be the older and the younger will be the this lower bed will be the oldest, and the upper beds, these they will be the youngest beds. Okay, this is the relationship between slatic cleavage of a fold. See, again I am telling you, if these slatic cleavages, these are the slatic cleavages, if they are parallel to the, this is the axial plane, if they are parallel to the axial plane, it means your strata, your fold are vertical, it means your folds are right, these beds are right side up. Okay, see, now the second case is, if the cleavage dips in the same direction as the bedding. Okay, this is the bedding. Okay, these are the bedding planes, and these are the cleavage planes. Okay, they are dipping in the same direction, and the cleavage planes are dipping at more angle, means their angle is very steep, means they are steeply dipping. It means that the beds are, these are right side up. Okay, and the synclinal axis means the closure of the fold, the synclinal closure that will be in the direction of the bedding direction. Okay, in which the bedding these bedding planes are dipping, that will be the direction of your syncline. Okay, that will be the closure of syncline. Here you won't expect any anticline. Again, the third case is that if the cleavage and bedding dip in opposite direction, like in this part, this is the bedding direction and this is the cleavage direction, they are dipping opposite to one another. In this case also, the beds are right side up and the direction of syncline is in the direction in which the bed is dipping. Here the bed is dipping towards the right, so the synclinal that we get, that will be in the right side.
Okay.
So you see what is the use of this structure? Sometimes in field you won't be able to find the whole structure altogether. Sometimes you will find only this part, okay? By determining the relationship between your bedding planes and your schistosity or cleavage planes, you can determine where is the closure of the fold, okay? Suppose in this case the beds are dipping in opposite direction, as we have seen in the third case. This bending, the direction of bending and the direction of cleavage planes, they are opposite to one another. And in this case the syncline will be towards the direction of the bedding. See here in figure C at F. Here what you will find is that the cleavage planes, they are dipping gently to the bedding planes. In this case the synclinal will be in the opposite direction to that of the dip. So this is the different case. Okay, again I am telling you, suppose the cleavage planes are dipping more gently than the bedding planes. In this case the your synclinal fold will be in the direction opposite to that in which your bedding is there. Okay, see again we'll see that if the bedding is dipping vertically, here you'll see the beds are dipping very steep or more or less vertical. Okay, in this case your syncline will be in the opposite direction in which the cleavage is dipping. Okay, this is the fifth case. Again suppose in the field you encounter this area, only this area in which only there is only this area in which there is beddings are very steep and the cleavage planes are a bit gentle. In this case the closure will be towards the in the direction in which in the direction opposite to the direction in which your cleavage planes are dipping.